Before we get to the main event, Bobby Heenan, you give me the name and telephone number of your doctor. I'm going to call him, and next Saturday on my exclusive hotline report, I'm going to fill the fans in on exactly what the doctor had to say regarding your condition.
That's right, and right after this program is over, I want people to call me on my hotline, and I'll tell you exactly what Hogan did to me. I'll go into detail and tell you what he called me, how I laid there on that floor. But please, do not give my doctor's name out or address or number.
I wouldn't do that. That's privileged information.
Thank you.
But
you'll see I'm not lying. I am legitimately 100% hurt.
1-900-909-9900. Kids, get your parents' permission. Bobby Heenan, this main event this week has got a little bit of something for everyone. Ricky Steamboat teaming up with Johnny B. Badd. They're facing World Television champ Lord Steven Regal and United States champ Stunning Steve Austin. There's firepower here.
Well, if you like high-flying maneuvers, you got it here. If you want on-the-mat wrestling, you got it here. If you want punching and kicking, you got it here. If you want all four men...
You are
men in the ring, you got it here. This may be one of the greatest tag matches next to the Rhodes Funk Bunkhouse Dunk match. Or,
let's not wait any longer. Let's get up to the ring this week for our main event.
All right, hi everyone, this is Tony Schiavone along with the living legend Larry Zbysko. And Larry, it's really great to be working with you again.
Of course it is.
And of course, we have some great tag team action. And I believe, Larry, the first time that we've ever seen Steamboat and Johnny B. Badd together.
Yeah, it's going to be an interesting situation here. You know, Johnny B. Badd, Ricky Steamboat, how are they going to communicate together inside that ring? It's going to be the questions. However, both their styles pretty much the same. They both got agility, fine movement, great shape. Of course, reputation of the Dragon precedes him worldwide. And Johnny B. Badd's repertoire is increasing by the week.
The Dragon, of course, the man who has a chance for the Clash of the Champions to become a U.S. heavyweight champion. As we await the U.S. champion, and here he comes along with the television champion, Lord Steven Regal and Stunning Steve together.
Now hold me back, Schiavone. Hold me back. Look at that jerk.
Hey, you know and I know, no one could hold you back if you really wanted to get somewhere.
And we will have this main event tag team action here on the main event after this from the Hulkster.
Hey, dudes, the Hulkster's running wild on WCW. And I want to tell you all about it right now.
Call the Hulk Hogan hotline at 1-900-737-HULK.
It's got 8 incredible options, like Beat the Hulk, Hulk trivia, and one of my great Hulk messages. There's always something new on the Hulk Hogan hotline.
Call now at 1-900-737-HULK. Calls cost $1.49 per minute. Kids get parents' permission. Charges will appear on parents' phone bill.
The bell, and here we are, set to go for tag team action. It's going to be Johnny B. Badd against Stunning Steve, two men who are very familiar with each other. They've had some great battles for the U.S. title over the past couple of pay-per-views. And Badd in there now against Stunning Steve, who works on that arm. He wants to take his hands away from him quickly here.
You know, it's going to be interesting here, probably in the favor of Johnny B. Badd and Ricky the Dragon. Stunning Steve and Lord Regal, how are these two guys going to communicate with the egos they both have? You know, both very good. Stunning Steve, very tenacious. Lord Regal, great mad wrestler. But their attitude, they're like baseball players. You know, give me the $10 million and I won't wrestle.
Side of the head. Look at this. We've got a fight going on here. Two men who will go at it at the upcoming Clash of the Champions for the U.S. title. And Steamboat wasting no time. Over the top goes the U.S. champ. And then down goes the U.S. champ. And he's in the wrong corner now.
Yeah, that's unusual when Austin doesn't know where he is in that ring. There, he figured it out now, but he was dazed.
Larry, you know, in the U.S. title bout at the Clash of the Champions, Austin has that Steamboat does, has a disqualification rule waived, which means if Austin gets disqualified, he'll lose the title.
Yeah, well, you can only take shortcuts, you know, for so long. But, hey, the way I look at it, when man gets in the ring against another man, forget the disqualifications. Let's go to the pin or the submission.
Spoken like the real man that you are.
Thank you.
And uppercut. And the Steamboat caught in the corner by Lord Steven Regal, a man who, of course, became the television champion.
By cheating.
By cheating over the man to my right, Larry Zbysko. Certainly a moment you won't forget. But that was a great title reign for you, though, Larry. Well, down goes Steamboat.
I proved to the world who's the best mat technician, so I rest my case.
You sure did. knees to the nose. Thank you, and a front chancery now. Here comes the double team. Stunning Steve is in. Stunning Steve, if you're thinking about is he a good tag team wrestler or not, then you have to only think back to a couple of years ago when he and Flying Brian were the world tag team champions, the Hollywood Blondes.
Oh, yeah, Austin knows what to do, and there's no question about it. I mean, ring positioning, the value of the quick tag right there. Took Steamboat over right in his corner. He's on top of the man, but he's only an arm's reach away from Lord Regal. So these guys know what they're doing. See if their egos can maintain that level of balance.
And here's a bit of trivia for you.
Good.
The Hollywood Blondes World Tag Team title reign came at the to an end. And who was Stunning Steve's partner? It was Lord Steven Regal. A year ago, the Hollywood Blondes and Flying Brian suffered an injury. Regal took his place in a title bout 1 year ago almost to the day. And then they went on to lose the titles. So really, the Blondes never lost the belts. Here's a tag. Here comes Johnny B. Badd. Uppercut.
Oh.
Wow, Johnny B. Badd with right hands abound now. Big back buddy drop.
He's
on the attack again. Elbow.
Elbows, knees, everything went flying there. And Johnny B. Badd, he got the worst end of it. Again, proving the tenacity of Stunning Steve Austin. I mean, this guy's like wrestling a pit bull.
Absolutely. And now the world television champion, Lord Steven Regal.
That's cruel right there. I mean, Regal knows how to make you suffer.
And Larry, you know a lot about his opponent, the upcoming Clash of the Champions, Antonio Inoki. And that's going to be quite a matchup.
Oh, yeah, it'll be good. We know Antonio Inoki is to Japan what I am to the world, you know, living legend.
What you are to golf, at least. There's a tag.
That, too.
And a double team. Great double team maneuvering here. And there's no question about it that the team of Stunning Steve and Lord Steven Regal look the best.
Yeah, they got it together. They're way ahead on points. Their ring positioning is perfect. Taking advantage of the legal 4 seconds. Johnny B. Badd is in trouble.
Up and down. Vertical suplex. Steve with a cover. One, two. Johnny B. Badd out in two. Wow. And he's smack dab in the middle of the ring here. Stunning Steve putting the pressure on. Clash of the Champions. Everybody awaiting Hulk Hogan and Ric Flair in the big title matchup. You got a prediction there, Legend?
Well, I predict we're going to see a different Ric Flair, much more vicious than we saw in the first encounter. But, boy, it's a toss of the coin, Tony. Toss of the coin.
He says he has a surprise for the Hulkster, and we'll see what it is.
I bet he does.
I bet he does, too. Up is Johnny B. Badd. Ducking is Johnny B. Badd. And going down hard is Johnny B. Badd from a great back body drop.
You know, you can see the importance of physical conditioning and endurance right here. Johnny B. Badd would have got beat minutes ago if he didn't have the stamina he did. Hey, here's a high-risk maneuver he don't have to take. Oh!
Whoa, my goodness. He took it anyway.
Here's the break they've been looking for. If Johnny B. Badd realizes where he is in that ring, it may be too late.
The exchange on one end, the World Television Japan, and here comes Steamboat. So two fresh men are in. Steamboat and Regal. Mexican arm drag. Make it two. Scoop slam.
Whoa.
Whoa, a fist press almost. Steamboat. He's taking on both men for crying out loud.
But the Dragon's the fresh man. In great shape. He's going. He's got to make the move.
Regal is the legal man here.
It's legal Regal.
Yeah, yes it is. Here's the double team now. A reversal. Steamboat.
Oh, right. He got him.
You're right. It was not the legal man. He had a pin on Stunning Steve there.
Yeah, but Austin should get out here. Regal's the legal man.
Badd is outside. Where's Johnny B. Badd?
Hey, tripping.
He's tripping up Regal. And a win. One, two, three.
That's not right.
How did that happen? Steamboat pins the U.S. champion nonetheless. And it certainly gives him momentum in his title match at the upcoming Clash of the Champions.
Yeah, yeah, momentum and embarrassment to Austin, but this isn't legal. I mean, where's Commissioner Bockwinkel when you need something boring said here? That wasn't fair. I can prove this.
Well, little Sir William says Regal was legal. And here it is again, Larry.
Well, I'm not sticking up for Regal, but he was the legal man. Watch this. Johnny B. Bad rips the Lord, and Steamboat pins the illegal man. There's the legal man on his back. Revenge is sweet at the Clash of Champions.
From another angle, the reversal, the roll-up, and the 1-2-3. Steamboat with the momentum heading to the Clash as he and Johnny B. Bad come away with a win here on the main event.